Welcome to my channel. In this video we will see about steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm, or in other words we can say it gradient search algorithm. Okay, so before explaining its algorithm part, let me explain you what is the steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm and how it is different from your basic hill climbing algorithm. Okay, what happen, this is the path. Suppose from here to here, these are the one path in which you have to find the your goal node. What happen in the hill climbing algorithm, that you can make this node and you check with its just neighbor node whether it is better or not. Okay, but when you come in a steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm, at that time you will check this node with all its neighboring nodes. And if you find any best node in which the heuristic cost is less, at that time you can make that node the current state and then you can go ahead. So this is different. This is the difference between the steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm and the normal your basic hill climbing algorithm. Now question comes, why we are using steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm then? So in the steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm, you can find optimal solution very quickly. So this is the advantage, therefore we are using this method. But if we are using this method, there it has some disadvantages also. What is the disadvantages? Then your time complexity will increase and your space complexity will increase. Okay, so this is so how tight time complexity will increase, because you have to compare all its successor node in a one shot. So at that time your time complexity will increase. And why space complexity will increase? Because you have to keep all the nodes value in the memory while comparing. So at that time your space complexity will increase. So this is the disadvantages of this method. And just I told you what is the advantages, what is the advantage, that you will get quickly optimal solution, quickly optimal solution you can get. Okay, so this is the advantage and disadvantages. But rest of the problems that were with the hill climbing algorithm, that is the local maxima, plateau, ridges, will also be remain in the steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm also. Okay, so till you understood the basic concept, now we will see its algorithm part. So I have written here the algorithm part of the steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm or gradient search algorithm. So before explaining this algorithm, let me clear the whole concept of this algorithm. Okay, suppose this is the path in which we want to find out our goal node. So what we will do, we will make this first node as a initial node. Okay, initial node, or we can define here initial state to this node. Now we will check that this is the node that we wanted to search or not. Means if it is a goal node, then we will print the success, then come out. Otherwise what we'll do, we'll continue our loop till then the path is completed fully, or if we find any goal node, in both the cases then it will come out from the loop. In these two conditions the loop will come out. Okay, so how it will be performed? As I told in hill climbing algorithm, that initial state will check just its successor, and if it is better than it, then it will meet the current state. But what will happen in steepest ascent hill climbing algorithm, that this initial state will check all the nodes of its successor, and whatever node it will get as the best node, means which is the best heuristic cost of this node in between all the paths, then it will make this that node as a current. So what will happen at that time? You will save your time and you can speedily get the optimal solution. That means you need not to compare both the nodes, neighboring nodes, at the same time. Okay, so in this case you can check here initial node with all the nodes at a one shot, and if you get any best successor, then you can change. Or if you are getting the goal node, as I told, then it will come out, or if the iteration is full, then it will come out. But if both the conditions are not there, and if you are checking all the its successor node in this path, the best successor node, so it, this current initial state will replace with that current node. So this is the whole concept of the algorithm. Okay, now we will see the its algorithm part, how it will work. So the first point I told you that evaluate the initial state. If it is a goal state, then print success and quit, otherwise continue with the initial state as the current state. Just I told ki if this initial state has a goal, then we will print success and come out. Otherwise, what will happen? It will go to the second step. Then second step, what it will do? It will continue from this node to this node. Then it will come out. Otherwise, if any goal node it will check, if it will find in between these, then it will come out. Okay. And if both the condition are not, then what it will do in between, it will check the best successor and this initial state that we have made, it is the current state, then it will check to the its best successor, and we will define it as a SUCC successor. We will define this keyword as successor. Okay, this will go on. So that second point I have written, loop until a solution is found or until a complete iteration produces no change to the current state. Till then, these 1, 2 condition and 3 condition will continue. So what is the first? Let successor be a state such that any possible successor of the current state will be better than successor. So just I told, if you get any successor which has a better solution than its current, so you will make it as successor key and successor node. Okay. And for each operator that applies to current state, apply the operator and generate a new state. What will happen? How you will check with the successor? You will make the current node to its new state, and new state will check with the current state. And if it is better, then you will define. If new state is better than the current state, then new state will be called as a successor. Evaluate the new state. Just I told, if it is a goal state, then print success and quit. Once again, it will check if it is goal or not. If it is not, compare it to successor. If it is better than the set successor to this state, if it is not better, then leave the successor alone. Means if it is not a better, then new state will be given there and we will not provide the success word here. And if it is better, then we will provide. If successor is better than the current state, then set the current state to the successor. So just I told ki if new this successor is better than the current, then you can provide this as a successor node, otherwise it will come out. So if you are not getting the point, just think this whatever I have written clearly, so you will get the point. Okay, so I hope you understood the concept. So like and share my videos, and watching more videos on artificial intelligence, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.